World-renowned sewing machine expert Alex Askaroff describes the improved tailor as being, in the late 1870s, the Rolls-Royce of sewing machines. Looking at this restored example, it's easy to believe. Besides displaying elegant style and beautiful artwork, these machines also feature superb design and machining. Dating improved tailors is an exercise in frustration because there are no serial number records for them and they were produced by a confusion of different companies. This one has a patent date of 1876, so it can't be any earlier than that. The Lippmann and Linn patent logo on the drive wheel suggests it was made in Germany by Lippmann and Linn, who were in partnership with Taylor for a few years. If anyone seeing this video has information to help narrow down its production date, I'd appreciate their mentioning it in the comments section below. Thank you. Two unique design elements of this improved tailor are that instead of the shuttle moving in a straight line or an arc, it moves in an ellipse, and that in place of belts or gears linking the drive wheel to the machine, a friction drive is employed. Let's move in closer for a better view of these unusual features. Here's the elliptical shuttle movement. The idea was that by eliminating the hard stops at the ends of the strokes of the linear and vibrating shuttles used in other machines, it would also eliminate the rattles and shaking associated with those stops. Improved tailors came with either belt drives or this unusual friction drive. Lowering this handle drops the drive wheel down onto the sewing machine's pulley, which fits into a groove on the drive wheel. This groove is machined with a slight taper that creates a wedging effect, greatly increasing the pressure between the two wheels to a point where it doesn't slip when sewing. At least that's the theory. In practice, this drive system can slip when transitioning from thin to thick layers of material. Tightening down on this screw pushes against a spring, which increases the downward force of the drive wheel, which should reduce this problem. We'll test this later to see if it works. The improved tailors have a couple of idiosyncrasies, which are useful to know if you're lucky enough to have one of these machines. The first is that on the take-up arm, this nut is a left-handed thread, which means if you need to take this off for maintenance, you need to rotate this nut clockwise to loosen it up, not counterclockwise, like in most screws. The other is that the main drive wheel needs to have a little bit of play on its axle, about a 16th to an eighth of an inch. Without this play, the pulley won't lock into the groove and the bobbin winder won't be able to lock in and engage on the wheel. To wind the bobbin, move the bobbin winder up so that it engages the main wheel and just turn away. Place the bobbin in the shuttle so that the thread comes out from the far side, goes over this arc, and then threads out through this first hole. Loop it back and forth through the holes to get as much tension as you want. Then bring it down and out through the slot in the side. Just like that. To thread, bring the thread over through the tensioner, over and through this guide hole from back to front, up to the take-up arm again from back to front, down between the horizontal arm and the drive arm, through the guide hole at the bottom of the needle bar, and then through the eye of the needle from right to left. Once the machine's threaded, bring the bobbin thread up in the usual manner and sew away. Here the machine is transitioning from two layers to six, and I didn't experience any slippage. Which doesn't mean it won't happen if you're trying to bump over a heavy seam. I hope you enjoyed this look at an 1870s improved tailor sewing machine. Our next restoration project is an 1871 Franklin and Genoria, which many people claim to be the most beautiful sewing machine ever created. You'll be able to judge for yourself in a couple of months. Until then, to see more of the machines in our collection, I hope you'll visit my main website at waynesthisandthat.com. And as always, thank you very much for watching.